cerebral and superior cerebellar artery. I think you have learned the posterior cerebral and superior cerebellar artery in Circle of Willis. Circle of Willis padhdakheri yo padhyo hola hai, the branches. Now next one is, this nerve will pass between free and attached margin of the tentorum cerebelli. Then it will pass through the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. I'll show you the cavernous sinus. Now can you see? This is the pituitary gland. On the side of the pituitary gland, we have the cavernous sinus. These are the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. Now what are the cranial nerve? Occlumatic nerve is there. Trochlear nerve is there. Ophthalmic V1 and V2. So all those are related on the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. What will be the content of the cavernous sinus? Internal carotid artery and the abducens nerve. Now what will be the course of the occlumatic nerve? When it come out from the midbrain, it will pass between posterior cerebral artery and superior cerebellar artery. It will pass between the free and the attached margin of the tentorum cerebelli. Then it will relate to the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. You can see the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. Then next one, it will enter into the orbit through the superorbital fissure after dividing into superior and the inferiorems. Now you can see over here, can you see the division? After passing through the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus, this one is dividing into the superioramus and the inferioramus, and finally entering into the orbit through superorbital fissure. So this is the course of occlumatic nerve. Now you can see over here also, this is the occlumatic nerve dividing into the superior branch or rami or the inferior branch. Now the superior branch is supplying levator palpebral superiors, superior rectus. Inferior branch is supplying medial rectus, inferior oblique, inferior rectus. That means all muscle except lateral rectus and superior oblique will be supplied by occlumatic nerve. Is it clear this one?
Yes, ma'am.
Now next one is, what do you mean by the ciliary ganglia? What is the preganglionic parasympathetic outflow from the Edinger-Westphal nucleus? Now see, from the Edinger-Westphal, you same way, I'll repeat this, okay? From the Edinger-Westphal nucleus, the preganglionic parasympathetic outflow will come. It will follow the course of occlumatic nerve. That means it will pass through the occlumatic nerve, through the inferior ramus of the occlumatic nerve. It will enter into the ciliary ganglia. It will interrupt at that level. Now from there, the postganglionic fiber will travel through the short ciliary nerve and finally supply the ciliary muscle and sphincter pupillae. So this is the overall course of preganglionic parasympathetic outflow of occlumatic nerve. Now, so this is a summary for you, the occlumatic nerve. What is the function? What are the functional component? One is the somatic efferent. Next one is general visceral efferent. Location, midbrain, motor nucleus, Edinger-Westphal nucleus. How it come out from the cranium or the skull? From the superior orbital fissure, it is going to supply the extraocular muscle, except SO and LR or superior oblique and lateral rectus. Movement of eyeball is the main action. Sphincter pupillae, ciliary, pupil constriction, accommodation. So this is the overall summary of occlumatic nerve. Now, is it clear, occlumatic nerve? The next one is, what do you mean by the occlumatic nerve palsy? That means this occlumatic nerve, motor nucleus of the occlumatic nerve is supplying the extraocular muscle. So there may be a ptosis. Ptosis means drooping of upper eyelid. Now, can you see the drooping of upper eyelid over here? This one, and over here also, you can see the drooping of upper eyelid. Drooping of upper eyelid. Now, why there is the drooping of upper eyelid? Because levator palpebral superiors, which is responsible for elevating the upper eyelid, is not working. It is paralyzed. So we have the drooping of upper eyelid. Now, next one is external external squint. So external squint, when I go, the eye will look laterally and downward. Now can you see? That is squint. That has a name, no? Lateral and downward. Now why the eye or the pupil will move to the lateral side? Because the lateral rectus, because the medial rectus is paralyzed, and the medial rectus is supplied by the occlumatic nerve. So the medial rectus will paralyze, and the lateral rectus, which is present on the lateral side, pupil neurites. Okay, so that will pull the pupil laterally, or that will pull the eye laterally, so the eye will look lateral. Now diplopia, double vision, dilated and fixed pupil. You know why there is a dilatation? Because the sphincter pupillae or the constriction pupillae is paralyzed. Why there is a loss of accommodation? Because the muscle, extraocular muscle, are paralyzed. And next one is sphincter pupillae, ciliary muscles are also paralyzed. Now next one is proptosis, prominence of eyeball, because most of the muscles of the eye are paralyzed. That's why there will be the relaxation. As a result, the eye will just come slightly anteriorly. That is known as the proptosis. So these are the applied aspect of the oculomotor nerve. Now if you have any confusion related to the oculomotor nerve, then you can ask me. Otherwise, I'll move to other cranial nerve. Hello. Is a sunnu pani oculomotor nerve?
Sorry, ma'am.
Okay. Now next, which one is the fourth cranial nerve? Fourth cranial nerve is the trochlear. Trochlear nerve is the fourth cranial nerve. Now, what type of nerve is this?
Motor.
Motor. Now, what is the function component of the trochlear nerve?
Somatic efferent.
Same. Somatic efferent. And does this have the preganglionic parasympathetic outflow?
No.
No. That means oculomotor nerve, trochlear nerve, and next one is the abducens nerve, because this is the trochlear nerve, which is the 4-1, and mnemonic scutio SO4 and LR is 6, lateral rectus by 6. So 4 cranial nerve, 4th cranial nerve, 6th cranial nerve, and the 3rd cranial nerve will have the same functional component, that is the somatic efferent. Is it clear, this one? Now next one is, this is the only cranial nerve that will come out from the posterior surface of the brainstem. Now when you see the ventral surface of the brainstem, most of the cranial nerve are emerging out from the ventral surface, but the trochlear nerve is coming out from the dorsal side of the brainstem, and it might come in your MCQ. Which of the following cranial nerve will arise from the dorsal aspect of the brainstem? Okay. And this is decussating with another cranial nerve, another trochlear nerve of the opposite side, and this is coming anteriorly. Now this is going to supply SO4, that means superior oblique muscle. Now the nuclear origin, you can see over here, when you see the cross section at the level of the inferior colliculus, then at the anterior part of the gray matter, you will have the trochlear nuclei. So this is the trochlear nucleus. Now what is the course of the trochlear nerve? Immediately it will decussate with the opposite side when it come out from the posterior surface of the midbrain. Then next one, then it will emerge out. Can you see this part of the trochlear nerve? Now it is emerging out from, okay, so it will be emerging out from the posterior surface of the midbrain at level of the inferior colliculus and on each side of the frenulum villi. Then it will pass forward. Okay. So then it will pass laterally, then it will pass posteriorly, anteriorly, or lateral to the cross cerebri. So by the side of the cross cerebri, on the lateral side of the cross cerebri, we can see the trochlear nerve. Now later on, this is also the another cranial nerve which will pass through the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. So this is the trochlear nerve which will pass through the middle cranial fossa in the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. Then it will exit through the cranium. So how it is going to exit through the cranium? Through the supraorbital fissure, same one. You can see this one is a supraorbital fissure. This one is the lateral part. This is the intermediate part and this is the middle part. Now can you see the trochlear nerve? So you can see, okay, so this one. Can you see the trochlear nerve? So this is the trochlear nerve which will pass through the lateral part of supraorbital fissure, and this will enter into the orbit and finally supply the supraoblique muscle. Now can you see this muscle which is winding? This one is a supraoblique, and this is the trochlear nerve. This is supplying the supraoblique muscle. So this is the overall course of the trochlear nerve. Now the trochlear nerve is supplying the Superior oblique muscle. Now see this diagram. Your diagram made, right? So this is the medial side. This is the lateral side. We have the medial rectus over here. We have the lateral rectus. And over here, we have to write the superior oblique. You class very orbit eyeball mounts, right? Your function or action of all those extraocular muscles. Now just see over here. Now just see the superior oblique. What will be the action of the superior oblique? The superior oblique muscle is causing the depression of the eyeball and abduction of the eyeball. So abduction and the depression will be caused by the superior oblique. That is the action of the superior oblique. Now just imagine if the trochlear nerve is damaged, then superior oblique muscle is paralyzed. Now what will happen? The eye will, you will not be able to turn eye downward and laterally. So you will have difficulty in turning the eye downward and laterally. So this is the applied aspect of the trochlear nerve. Then you will have the double vision when you are looking lateral and downward. And you can see over here the eye is just, the eyeball or the pupil. So over here, this is just present above the horizontal line. So this is the applied aspect of the trochlear nerve. Is it clear, the trochlear nerve?
Yes,
ma'am. Okay. Now I'll move to another one that is known as the abduction. I'll be teaching the fifth cranial nerve later on, because this is the abduction nerve. This is also supplying the extraocular muscle. So together with other cranial nerve, trochlear and the oculomotor nerve, I'll be teaching the abduction nerve as well. So the abduction nerve is also motor nerve. The functional component is same, that is the somatic efferent. Now the nuclear origin. For the nuclear origin, you have to see the floor of the fourth ventricle. Maile the practical ma bhanda pani floor of the fourth ventricle ma, you can see the abduction nerve. This is the abduction nerve which is winding by the facial nerve. This is the abduction nuclei which is winding by the facial nerve, and this is producing some elevation that is known as the facial colliculus. So what is the look, what will be the nuclear origin of the abduction nuclei? It is present in the posterior surface of the bones, or in the floor of the fourth ventricle, in the facial colliculus, just beneath the facial colliculus. That is the location of abduction nucleus. Now next one is superficial origin. Now this one is the superficial origin. Now the superficial origin is, it is on the pontomedullary junction above the pyramid. So this is the abduction nerve. Now the course, it will also pass through the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. You can see this is the, okay, so this one is the abduction nerve. So it will pass, it will not pass through the lateral wall, it will be the contain of cavernous sinus along with the internal carotid artery. So it will be present lateral to the internal carotid artery. It will pass through the cavernous sinus and it will enter through the into the orbit through the supraorbital fissure. Can you see the supraorbital fissure over here? And can you see the abduction nerve? So it will pass through the intermediate area of the supraorbital fissure and enter into the orbit and supply the lateral rectus muscle. So this one is the lateral rectus. Now you can see this is the lateral rectus and this is the abduction nerve. Now what will be the action of the abduction nerve? The lateral rectus means the lateral rectus, what will be the action of the lateral rectus? The lateral rectus will pull the eyeball laterally. But whenever you have the lesion in the abduction nerve, the lateral rectus muscle will paralyze. As a result, the person will be unable to turn eye laterally and you'll have the internal squint due to the unopposed action of the medial rectus. Is it clear, this one? Keso sonnoborni? Hello?
Hi, no, ma'am.
Next one is the trigeminal nerve. The fifth cranial nerve is the trigeminal nerve, and this one is the largest cranial nerve, and the nuclei of the trigeminal nerve will extend throughout the brainstem. Now can you name What type of nerve is the trisomal nerve?
Mixed type.
It is the mixed one. It consists of both motor, it consists of both sensory. That means what will be the functional component? Kiki owns a functional component.
Special visceral efferent.
Special visceral efferent. Okay, good. Then?
General somatic efferent.
General somatic efferent ki afferent?
Afferent.
Afferent. General somatic efferent boy, when the preganglionic outflow didn't show. This is GSA. Now see, what you have to do is a functional component. Yad gonna garo so. Tapurlay, I'm asking you, is it difficult to memorize the functional component? हेलो खै त कसले रेस्पोन्स गर्नु न त
बुझेपछि इजी नै छ
म पक्का म अरूहरूलाई भन्छु है ल तिमीलाई त इजी छ म अरूलाई सी फर्स्ट वाट यु हेभ टु डु इज द ट्राइजमल नर्व सपोज लेट अस टेक एन एक्जाम्पल अफ द ट्राइजमल नर्व इज द मिक्स्ड वान यु एभ्री वान मोस्ट अफ यु नो दिस वान है इट इज कन्सिस्ट अफ द सेन्सरी पार्ट इट कन्सिस्ट अफ द मोटर पार्ट द्याट मिन्स यु विल हेभ द फङ्सनल कम्पोनेन्ट एज ई एन्ड ए. This is the afferent, this is the efferent, because it is the mixed one only, because efferent pani hunu paryo, afferent pani hunu paryo. Now what you have to do is you have to find out the function of the trisomal nerve. Of trisomal nerve le ke garcha? The trisomal nerve is supplying the muscle of mastication. Most of you know the muscle of mastication is supplied by the trisomal nerve. Now a muscle of mastication kaha bata auncha? The muscle of mastication will arise from the pharyngeal arches. The first pharyngeal arches. Now just recall our first class. The muscle, if anything will innervate the muscle derived from the first pharyngeal arch, then that is the special visceral efferent. Our special visceral efferent, apart from the trisomal nerve, what are the other nerve that will have the same functional component? Trisomal nerve, like or kun nerve, just cause special visceral efferent unsa.
Facial nerve,
because the second pharyngeal arch, then glossopharyngeal nerve, that is the third pharyngeal arch, you know. Then we have the fourth and sixth, that is the vagus. Vagus axis. Now those will be having the same functional component. Now next one is, we have with the this one is the sensory. The trisomal nerve is also the sensory one. So we have the afferent also. Now the trisomal nerve is sensory. Ma ke garcha ta kun part hamro body ko kun part bata it will carry the sensation. It will carry the sensation from mainly from the face area. That's why we keep this one as a general somatic afferent, because it is carrying the general sensation, not the special one. Hai ab special bhako bhai ke hunthyo visceral afferent hunthyo, but it is not carrying the special sensation. It is carrying the pain, toss, pressure, temperature, those general sensations. So we have the general somatic afferent. So it is carrying the exteroceptive and proprioceptive. Bhaneko thas hola, exteroceptive bhaneko outside, it may be a toss, pressure, temperature, pain. Proprioceptive bhaneko muscle and joint sensation. So from cornea, skin of face, scalp, eyelid, nose, paranasal sinus, nasal cavity, teeth of upper jaw. So from this area it will carry the general sensation, and carry the general sensation. Now general sensation lead ayo kanira lo rakhne. So we have the nucleus for that one, which will sense each different sensation. We have the principal, spinal, mesencephalic. These are the three different types of sensory nucleus of the trisomal nerve. Now next one is special visceral efferent. It will, because it is supplying the muscle derived from the first pharyngeal arch, that is the muscle of mastication, and those will be represented by motor nucleus. I'll show you the nucleus of the trisomal nerve. So we have the motor nucleus. This is the motor one. We have the long sensory one. We have the mesencephalic, principal and the spinal. Our each could different functions. So the spinal will receive pain and temperature sensation. The principal will receive torque and pressure. Mesencephalic, this one, will receive joint muscle and joint sensation. Now just first move to this sensory or the principal nucleus. So the principal nucleus of the trigeminal nerve is present within the bones. It will continue below with the spinal nucleus and above with the mesencephalic nucleus. Now the spine, this one is the principal. So it will receive the fiber of the torch and pressure. Now next one is the spinal nucleus. The spinal nucleus will extend throughout the medulla oblongata up to C2. तपाईहरुले spinal cord को cross section हेर्नुभयो भने when you see object the cross section of the spinal cord and not the cross section भन्दा पनि when you see the nucleus of the spinal cord को nucleus हेर्नुभयो भने over there you'll come across the spinal nucleus of the trigeminal त्यो पनि याद गर्नु है because C2 सँग extend हुन्छ now this spinal nucleus will receive the fiber of the pain and temperature. The next one is the mesencephalic nucleus. The mesencephalic nucleus is present within the brainstem or within the midbrain around the cerebral aqueduct. So you can see this one is the mesencephalic nucleus. It is present within the gray matter of the midbrain, no, around the cerebral aqueduct, and this is going to receive the proprioceptive sensation, maniko muscle and joint sensation. It will receive the pain from the muscle of mastication, a pain bhanda pani general sensation from the muscle of mastication, facial expression, TMJ, extraocular muscle. So all the muscle and joint sensation of those area will be received by mesencephalic nucleus of the trigeminal nerve. Now next one is the motor nucleus. Now see, this one is the motor nucleus over here. Now the motor nucleus take care of the motor nucleus of the trigeminal nerve will supply the muscle of mastication, and it is having the functional component as special visceral efferent. Now where is the motor nucleus? The motor nucleus is somewhere over here. Can you see? This is the motor, this one is the sensory. The bigger one is the sensory, the smaller one is the motor. It is situated within the pons, just medial to the principal nucleus of the trigeminal. It will supply the muscle of mastication, those muscle of mastication plus other muscles which are arised or which are derived from the first pharyngeal arches. The first pharyngeal arches but only kiki muscle, muscle of mastication, anterior belly of digastic, mylohyoid, tensor belly palatini, tensor tympani. These are all the muscle arising or derived from the first pharyngeal arches. Now next is the superficial origin. Now just see the superficial origin. Can you see the superficial origin? We have the larger one and we have the small one. The larger one is the sensory, the small one is the motor. So it will emerge out from the ventral surface of the bones, as a motor and as a sensory. The sensory is the bigger one and the motor is the small one. It will come out. Now is it clear till now? Kesa, Isma, no. Trigeminal nerve, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now next one is, what is the course of the trigeminal nerve? It will run forward. Now just see, when it come out from the ventral surface of the pons as a motor root and the sensory root, then it will run forward and it will rest on the upper surface of the apex of the petrous part of the temporal bone. Now just see, this is the interior of the cranium, This one, can you see the rock-like structure? This is known as the petrous part of the temporal bone. Now, can you see this part? This is the apex on the upper surface of the petrous part of the temporal bone. This one, somewhere over here, we have the trigeminal ganglia. So this is the trigeminal ganglia, which will be present in the impression that is present above the apex of the petrous part of the temporal bone. In a middle cranial fossa. Now you can see over here, this is the trigeminal ganglia. That means when it come out from the dorsal side, or sorry, when it come out from the ventral surface of the pons, then the sensory root will expand and it will form the trigeminal ganglia. Now from the anterior border of the trigeminal ganglia, we have the V1, V2, V3 will arise. That is the ophthalmic, maxillary, and the mandibular nerve. Now those will arise from the anterior border of those ganglia. Now how it will enter? Okay. Now how it will enter, it will enter into the, okay, so how it will come out from the cranium of the serum? This first, this see the ophthalmic, okay? Ophthalmic, it's not going to be so much. Okay, now this is the ophthalmic nerve. Yes, ma'am, please say. So from the ventral side, so from the anterior part of the trigeminal ganglia, we have the V1, V2, and V3. Now first stress the V1. The V1 is the ophthalmic nerve. Our ophthalmic nerve as a whole, kahin bata bahira aako ta hame thaha chaina, because ophthalmic nerve has got further branches. We have the lacrimal, frontal, and nasociliary. That means ophthalmic nerve will be divided into three branches: lacrimal, frontal, and nasociliary. And those branches will come out from the superorbital fissure, and that will enter into the orbit. Orbit one. That one. Okay. सब पे ऑर्बिट में जाते हैं ना ही, ओके, ओके, it will enter through the superorbital fissure, it will pass through the superorbital fissure and it will enter into the orbit. Orbit में overall content नहीं होयी, sorry. Now see the lacrimal. So this one is the lacrimal, this one is the frontal, which will pass through the lateral part of the superorbital fissure. Now next one, this is the nasociliary, which will pass through the intermediate part of the superorbital fissure and finally enter into the orbit. Ab orbit ma tapale theory class hunda practical class hunda ki you will see the lacrimal nerve, frontal nerve, and the nasociliary. Yo sabai dekhinchha tesma, so all will enter into the orbit. Yo bujhyo aba ophthalmic ko. Now just see, I'll repeat once again, eh? So this one is the trigeminal ganglia. This is the anterior border of the trigeminal ganglia, from where we have the three division, V1, V2, V3. The V1 is the ophthalmic, which is pure sensory. It is pure sensory. So the V1 nerve, this is the ophthalmic nerve, which will pass through the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. मैंने पहले अपनी बनाई थी. Cavernous sinus, it will pass through the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. Then it will enter into the orbit through the superorbital fissure after dividing into the three branches. So lacrimal, you can see the lacrimal, you can see the frontal nerve, and you can see the nasociliary. Now just trace the frontal nerve. When you trace the frontal nerve, it is further divided into supraorbital and supratrochlear. Those are the further branches of the frontal nerve, right? Supraorbital and supratrochlear. Now next, nasociliary ko the further branches are sign, okay, nasociliary. So this one is the nasociliary. No, which has got the branches like anterior and posterior ethmoidal, infratrochlear. Those are the branches. Can you see the infratrochlear nerve, anterior and the posterior ethmoidal nerve, and branch to the ciliary ganglia. Okay? So those are the branches of the nasociliary nerve. Now this one is the table for you. The ophthalmic nerve. What you have to know is ophthalmic nerve is V1. It is the pure sensory one. So sensory, we have the general somatic afferent, because this ophthalmic nerve is carrying the sensation from the particular area of our trigeminal ganglia. The branches exit out through the supraorbital fissure. We have the three branches: main, lacrimal, frontal, nasociliary. Supratrochlear, supraorbital are the two branches of the frontal nerve. Anterior, posterior, and infratrochlear are the three branches of the nasociliary nerve. Now, what is the V1? The V1, that means this will carry the sensation from the scalp, forehead, upper eyelid, nose, cornea, conjunctiva. So you can see over here, this one is the V1 area. Your trigeminal cuneo area. Eh? So from the scalp, from the forehead, from the upper eyelid, from the nose area. So this will carry the sensation from those area. Ophthalmic division of the trigeminal nerve. Is it clear this one? So next, I'll move to the maxillary nerve. Now, from the anterior part of the trigeminal ganglia, the V2 will arise, and this V2 is also the sensory one. You put it sensory, okay? Sensory, boy, basically, boy, it has the functional component as general somatic afferent. Now, it will also pass through the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. It will pass through the foramen rotundum. It will come out through the skull. thasai foramen rotundum, foramen ovule, what are the structure that pass that will pass through the foramen rotundum and foramen ovule? I think you know this one. Now it will come out through the foramen rotundum. It will enter into the pterygopalatine fossa. I've already taught you about the pterygopalatine fossa printhasa. It will enter into pterygopalatine fossa. Then it will pass through the infraorbital fissure. Can you see the infraorbital fissure over here? And finally, it will emerge out through the infraorbital foramen. So this is the overall course of the maxillary nerve. Bujhe bhaiyo? You bujhe abo? Hello?
Bujhe ma.
Now just see the branches of the maxillary nerve. What are the branches of the maxillary nerve? So this is the maxillary nerve. So the maxillary nerve has got the three different. This one is the intracranial because it is not coming out from the foramen rotundum. So this is the intracranial. Eh? So the intracranial part, ma, it has got the one branches that is known as the meningeal branch. But a branch is one is the meningeal branch. Now within the pterygopalatine fossa, it has the ganglionic branch. So those are the ganglionic branch. It is providing the branch to the pterygopalatine ganglia. So those are known as the ganglionic branches. Now next one is. Can you see one nerve going superiorly? This is known as the zygomatic nerve. Further dividing into zygomatic temporal, zygomatic facial. So this is the zygomatic nerve. Now next is, we have got this one. This is known as the posterior superior alveolar nerve. Can you see the three one? Anterior, middle, posterior. So all those are the superior alveolar nerve. Anterior, middle, posterior superior alveolar nerve. Now next, the final one, this is known as the infraorbital nerve, further divided into three. One, palpebrae, this one is the labial and middle alveolar. So those are the three branches. Just see, meningeal branch to the pterygopalatine ganglia, zygomatic nerve, superior alveolar, posterior, middle, anterior, infraorbital, palpebral, labial, nasal. Those are the branches of the maxillary nerve. And this nerve will carry the sensation from the lower eyelid, part of the side and ala of the nose, upper lip, maxillary region, and the temporal region. Now just see this region. So from this region, this will carry the sensation. Okay. So ala of nose, maxillary area over here, or some part of the temple also. Lower eyelid, urethra button. So I'll try to draw the branches of the maxillary nerve. So you know, maxillary nerve. What the maxillary nerve? The maxillary nerve. So this one, I'm just drawing the maxillary nerve. Maxillary nerve will come out through the trigeminal ganglia somewhere over here. Let us see, we have the trigeminal ganglia over here, and this one is the V1, which is going above your V1O. I'm just tracing the V2A. So this is the maxillary nerve, which will pass through the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus. Then somewhere over here, let us say somewhere over here, we have the foramen rotundum. It will enter into the pterygopalatine fossa. This one is the pterygopalatine fossa. Then it will enter into the infraorbital fissure canal, then it will come out through the infraorbital foramen. Somewhere I'll draw over here the infraorbital foramen. Is it clear this one? Bujhe abhi ho? The floor of the infraorbital fissure, then it will come out through the infraorbital foramen. And this is the foramen rotundum. Now what are the branches? This is the intracranial course, which is present inside the skull. So we have the one branches that is known as the meningeal branch. So this is the meningeal. Now this is the pterygopalatine fossa. Now somewhere over here, yani the double orbit my interval, eh? Okay. So this is the pterygopalatine fossa. Now in the pterygopalatine fossa, it gives rise to the branch to the pterygopalatine ganglia. So let us say these are the two branches which is hanging the pterygopalatine ganglia from above. So those are the ganglionic branches. Now next one is, when branches is going above, this is known as the zygomatic branch. Now next, we have the two from here, one, and this one is another one. So those two are posterior and middle superior alveolar nerve. So posterior and middle, लिखनु पर्छ पर्दैन है टाइम लाग्छ छोड्दियो posterior and middle superior alveolar nerve. Now what are the branches that will arise from the orbital part, infraorbital part? So from here one branches will arise, this is known as the anterior supra anterior superior alveolar nerve. This is anterior superior alveolar nerve. So we have the anterior, middle and posterior superior alveolar nerve. Now this is the infraorbital foramen. From here this will nerve will come out as infraorbital nerve, which is further divided into three branches. It is going towards the eye, palpable, going towards the nose, nasal, going towards the lip, labial. So these are the three terminal branches. Above you, this is the maxillary nerve. Hello?
Above you, ma'am.
Okay. Now, next. Now, next one. So, this one is the same thing. Eh? Same. Now, next one is the mandibular nerve. Now, mandibular nerve is a mixed one. It has got the, both the sensory component and both the motor component. Now, what will be the individual functional component of the mandibular nerve? As a sensory, we have the general somatic afferent. As a motor, we have the special visceral efferent. Now, see this one. This one is the mandibular nerve, which is the mixed one. It has got the sensory root. It has got the motor root. So this sensory root will pass downward from the trigeminal ganglia, and motor root will be somewhere over here. That will get unite, and that will pass through the foramen ovale. Okay, and that will unite to form the trunk. Now this one is the trunk. Your trunk, boy. This is the trunk. The trunk will enter into the infratemporal fossa, where they will divide into the anterior division and the posterior division. Bujhi ab yo. Ek se ma you need draw nai gardinchu puka timlai clear huncha. Okay, so I'm drawing the mandibular nerve. So the mandibular nerve, so suppose this one is the motor, suppose this one is the sensory. I'm ekdam wide gari chu yo ali nazikai huncha, and this is getting unite with each other from the trunk of the mandibular nerve. Now this is the foramen ovale. Oh, now when it exit out of the foramen ovale, it will get unite and form the trunk. So this is the trunk of the mandibular nerve. The trunk of the mandibular nerve will enter into the infratemporal fossa, where this will divide into the anterior division. This is the anterior division, and it is say this one is the posterior one. Ab bujhe hain sab? Now next one. So what you have to do is, you have to name the branches that is arising from the trunk, anterior division and the posterior division. Our anterior trunk, what are only branches? We just have the two branches. One is the meningeal branches that is known as nervous spinosum. Sunesa hola nervous spinosum, which will enter the skull through the foramen spinosum, and it will supply the meninges, that is the nervous spinosum. Next one is, this is known as the nerve to middle pterygoid. Your nerve to middle pterygoid. These are the two branches arising from the trunk. Boy of you? You buzio? Now next one is, see the anterior division. Now after it divide into the anterior division and the posterior division, now what are the branches arising from the anterior division? So from the anterior division, we have the one branches. This one. This one is supplying. Okay. This one is supplying the temporalis muscle. So this is known as a deep temporal nerve. Now next one, this one is the nerve supplying the masseteric nerve. This one is the nerve supplying the lateral pterygoid and the middle pterygoid. They supply garisam. So all four muscle of mastication: temporalis, middle pterygoid, lateral pterygoid, masseter. Now next one is we have got one sensory nerve that is known as the buccal nerve. So this is the buccal nerve. The buccal nerve is the sensory one. It is supplying the skin above the buccinator muscle. It will carry the sensation from the skin above the buccinator muscle. So this is the buccal nerve, which is the sensory. So all other four are motor. So this four are motor, this is the sensory one. So these are the branches arising from the anterior division. You buzio? Now next one is from the posterior division. So from the posterior division, we have the another nerve which is going above in front of the external acoustic meatus, that is known as auriculotemporal nerve, that will arise from the posterior. Now next one we have the one nerve. This is known as the lingual nerve. And next one we have with the infraalveolar nerve. This is known as the lingual nerve, this is the auriculotemporal nerve, and this is the infraalveolar nerve. Your lingual, your auriculotemporal nerve. This one is known as auriculotemporal nerve, and this is known as the infraalveolar nerve. अब लिङ्गुअल नर्भ त थाहा छ बाहिरबाट यहाँबाट के अट्याच हुन्छ द कोडा टिम्पेनिक नर्भ विल अट्याच टु द लिङ्गुअल नर्भ द्याट विल क्यारी द टेस्ट सेन्सेसन एन्ड द कोडा टिम्पेनिक नर्भ इज द ब्रान्च अफ द फेसियल सो द्याट इज द्याट विल अट्याच टु द लिङ्गुअल नर्भ त्यो लिङ्गुअल नर्भसँग अट्याच हुने हो दिस इज नट द ब्रान्च अफ द पोस्टेरियर रामस अफ द मेन्डिबुलर नर्भ है यो कोडा टिम्पेनिक नर्भ जस्ट विल अट्याच टु द लिङ्गुअल नर्भ एन्ड दिस इज द इन्फ्राल्भुलर नर्भ यो बुझ्यो अब यो दिस आर द थ्री ब्रान्चेस मेन थ्री ब्रान्चेस अरू ब्रान्चेस म भन्छु बुझ्यो भयो नाउ नेक्स्ट वान यु जस्ट रिड बाई युर सेल्फ दिस वान इज फ्रम द ट्रङ्क वी हेभ द मेनिन्जियल ब्रान्च नर्भ टु मिडल टेरिकोइड मेसेटेरिक नर्भ डिप टेम्पोरल नर्भ टु ल्याटरल टेरिकोइड बकल नर्भ विथ दिस विल अराइज फ्रम द एन्ट्री डिभिजन नाउ फ्रम द पोस्टेरियर डिभिजन क्यान यु सी फ्रम द पोस्टेरियर डिभिजन वी हेभ द ओरिकल टेम्पोरल नर्भ विच इज पासिङ बिहाइन्ड द एक्सटर्नल अकुस्टिक मिएटस ओरिकल टेम्पोरल नर्भ एन्ड दिस वान इज द लिङ्गुअल नर्भ यु क्यान सी द लिङ्गुअल नर्भ And this one is the infraalveolar nerve. Now this lingual nerve is carrying the general sensation from the anterior to third of the tongue. Now this lingual nerve is attached, or not attached, this lingual nerve correlation is present posterior to the third molar teeth. Posteriorly to the third molar teeth, that is the location of the lingual nerve in a bony part of the mandible. So while extracting the third molar teeth, the care must be taken not to damage the lingual nerve, because the lingual nerve is just lying inferior to the third molar teeth, just on a posterior side. Now next one is, this is the auriculotemporal nerve. So whenever we have the cancer in the tongue, or in the we are having the disease in the lower jaw, then the referred pain, the pain may be referred to the ear and the temporal region through the auriculotemporal nerve. So this one is another condition which you have to remember, upright endomy. The next one is the infraalveolar nerve. Now let's see, this is the infraalveolar nerve. This is the largest terminal branch of the posterior division. Now this will enter through the mandibular foramen. You can see the mandibular foramen over here, and this will run through the mandibular canal and finally emerge out through the mental foramen over here. So before entering into the mandibular foramen, this will give rise to another branch. Another branch will arise from the infraalveolar nerve, that is known as a nerve to mylohyoid. When you say infraalveolar nerve, mandibular foramen ma chhirnu bhanda pahila, it will give rise to a branch that is known as a nerve to mylohyoid. And this nerve to mylohyoid will supply the anterior belly and the mylohyoid muscle. Next, the infraalveolar nerve. Within the mandibular canal, it will give rise to the incisive nerve, the branches that is supplying the lower jaw, and next finally the mental nerve. So these are the other branches of the infraalveolar nerve. Don't get confused in the infraalveolar nerve. What you have to know is, in the infraalveolar nerve will mainly give the two branches. One is the nerve to mylohyoid, next one is the mental nerve. So this is all about the branches. So DSA, SBE, you saw the formula, okay. Now to apply textbook, the trigeminal nerve injury is hard to learn, you know. So whenever the muscle of mastication will paralyze on an affected side, then jaw will be debilitated to the opposite side. Now over here, ita tirago muscle paralyzed. And jaw will deviate towards the opposite side because the muscle of mastication of the opposite side will be in action and which will pull the jaw towards that side. There will be the loss of the facial expression. You can see the loss of the facial expression over here. The loss of the corneal reflex. And next one is the trigeminal neuralgia. The trigeminal neuralgia one, severe pain along the distribution of the nerve. So along the distribution of the trigeminal nerve or along the branches of the trigeminal nerve, the pain will radiate it along the branches of the trigeminal nerve, and you'll be having the severe pain over the face. That is all about the trigeminal neuralgia. You detail ma aur ma parno lai. Now this is all about the today's class. Now what you have to know is you have to know the functional component of each and every cranial nerve, and the most important, you have to know the trigeminal nerve, the branches of ophthalmic, maxillary, mandibular. What are the branches? What are the functional component? What are the areas supplied by the trigeminal nerve? All those. So the trigeminal nerve is very important. So if you have any confusion, then you can ask me. Tisha Sundapani, do you have any confusion or do you have any question? Hello?
Sorry, no.
Okay. एकछिन लिभ नगर्नु ल लिभ नगर्नु एकछिन वेट मैले त